At this point, ANSYS has the information necessary to calculate the potential energy from the pin displacements, and that's needed for it to be able to minimize, find the pin displacements in such a way that the potential energy is minimum. However, some of the pin displacements are known from the boundary condition, so let's specify those displacement constraints so that it can figure out which of the pin displacements are known. So if I go to the problem specification, I see that A is constrained in X, Y, and also Z. We have to constrain it in Z in ANSYS because it includes, when it writes a potential energy, it also can account for move for displacements in Z direction, but we don't have that. We don't have any effect of that in this problem. So we'll zero out all displacements here, and then over here we will zero out the Y displacement and also the Z displacement and leave the X displacement free, which has to be determined. So I'll go to mechanical and I'll highlight static structural and say supports displacement. And I will start with this pin over here or vertex, and it cannot move in X, Y, or Z. So all the displacements at that pin are known, or that vertex. And then let's put in the second displacement. I can also select the vertex and then say supports displacement. And I will say X is free, Y is zero, and Z is zero. Okay, so those displacements these two displacements are known at that vertex. So that completes the specification of the mathematical model. So let's save the project. At this point, we can ask ANSYS to find the pin displacements that are not known in such a way that the potential energy of the truss is minimized. That's what is coming up next.